Hello guys, welcome back to the Sonic G IGCSE biology video. So today we are going to do chapter 20, which is biotechnology and genetic modification. So what is biotechnology? So it's the exploitation of biological processes for the industrial and other purposes, especially the genetic manipulation of microorganisms for the production of antibiotics, hormones, and etc. So why are microorganisms used? It can be bacteria or microscopic fungi, of course. So it has no ethical issue. Okay, it has the same genetic material. It reproduces very fast, and it has plasmids used to transfer genes into bacteria. So yes, of course, it has a rapid reproduction rate, and it also can make more complex molecules. So it helps to control the over-manipulation and growth, and also the genetic code is being shared with other organisms also. So, using yeast, okay. So, we all know yeast from anaerobic respiration is to use to make bread, okay. So, yeast plus sugar together with oxygen is giving you carbon dioxide plus water plus higher energy. If yeast and sugar without oxygen giving you out carbon dioxide and alcohol and low energy, so you can say that carbon dioxide, it produces bread, it's a bread making, and alcohol can be used for any alcohol products from yeast, of course. So yes, this is the two things that yeast can be made into. Okay, the second thing is about distillation. Okay, so distillation is something happened in chemistry. Okay, one of the separating methods. So you can see that water and ethanol solution is being mixed here, and it's heated with heat, and it gives out pure ethanol vapor, and it starts to evaporate and condense, which is about 78 degrees. And then the cooling water comes out, and the vapor condenses into the condenser. The cooling water comes in, and you get the pure form of ethanol. Okay? So the next one is something also related, which is fermentation. So the fermentation is basically the anaerobic process, respiration of yeast in yeast. So by biochemists, anaerobic process that generate energy by the breakdown of organic compounds. So any process that generate bacteria metabolize as end products, lactic acid, enzymes, ethanol, butanol, and acetone. So by industrial users, is any aerobic process that produces microorganisms, biomass as the end product. Next one is biotransformation. Transformation of a compound by microbial cells. Okay? So using enzymes. Okay, so this is one of it where it is a stirrer to keep the microorganism nutrients and temperature evenly distributed. It has to be constant. And there are nutrients and microorganisms can enter in and the sterile air supply. So it is connected with a computer and the temperature and pH probes to monitor the mixture. And whatever comes out is product. And heating cooling water out is something like exothermic or endothermic reaction. Then this is the features of it. Okay. So we have the steam inlet. So the hot steam sterilizes the inside of the fermenter, and the reason is an aseptic precaution to prevent contamination by unwanted microorganisms. And with the nutrient inlet, allows sterile nutrients to enter the fermenter. So penicillin needs nutrients so that they can grow and reproduce. So the water jacket with cooling water keeps the temperature inside constant, which penicillin can grow best at optimum temperature of 23 degrees to 28 degrees. Next one is the air inlet. It provides a source of oxygen. So penicillin needs oxygen for aerobic respiration as usual because it's a real life thing. And filter on air inlet stops microorganisms getting inside the fermenter. And aseptic precaution to prevent contamination by unwanted microorganisms. Next one is the stirring paddles to keep the mixture inside the fermenter agitated, stirred. Mixes the microorganisms with the nutrients and keeps the temperature even. So the last one is the pH probe and intake valve for acid and alkali. So the pH inside the fermenter is monitored to check it is at the optimum value, because optimum pH is 6.5 for the fungus. Next one is biological washing, okay? Okay, the first one is called pectinase. So pectinase is, pectin helps to stick plant cells together. So pectinase breaks down pectin to extract juice, okay? And this is lactase. So lactase, it breaks down into lactose. It breaks down with lactase enzyme to give you galactose and glucose, okay? Before that, there are other things that we all should know also. So biological washing powders can be protease, which can break down into protein strains, and then lipases can be break down into fats, amylase is break down into starch, and cellulases is break down into cellulose fiber. Okay, so lactase is coming from milk, first of all. So it's a milk sugar that it can cause allergy because no lactase enzyme is produced in our body. So as age increases, the lesser lactase is produced, okay? Okay, so this is one example. You can have a read on this. It's... okay, this one is the to check whether it's present or not. This is the carbon dioxide indicator, So next one is penicillin. So penicillin, we all know from drugs, which is an antibiotic penicillin produced by the fungus penicillin. So this is the process of it produced in a fermenter. So this is a fermenter, okay? So the production of fermenter is penicillin is the fermenter is inoculated with the penicillin fungus. Then oxygen, carbohydrate, sugar, nutrients, ammonia, urea is added. Then it's kept at 30 degrees and pH 6.5. Then they extract the penicillin after 6 days. They sterilize the fermenter by radiation, increased pressure, increased temperature, and the process is repeated. So you can look deeply, what does this mean again? Okay, next one is genetic engineering. So genetic engineering is the deliberate modification of the characteristics of an organism by manipulating its genetic material. So examples can be insulin production, herbicide and pesticide resistant plants, or even golden rice. So it can be an insertion of human genes into bacteria to produce insulin, yes, insulin production, and insertion of genes into crop plants, golden rice, herbicide and pesticides in rest implants. So yes, this is another process of how it works. So this is some human cells are liquidized, the chemical added to make a DNA precipitate, restriction enzymes are added to cut into DNA into pieces, and the restriction enzymes and the sticky ends. So the pieces of human DNA containing the insulin gene are joined to cut plasmid using ligase enzymes. You don't really have to know a lot about this, but this is something that is linked with the fermenter also. Okay. So this is the complementary, the sticky ends, so plasmid and insert. You can see inside it has DNA, DACG, linking back to chapter 5 about this. Chapter 4, biological molecules. And then we got joints, backbone, it forms sugar phosphate. So see, something about enzymes, the active site, everything, it's there. So what are the advantages of genetic engineering? So its golden rice is high in vitamin A, insulin production by bacteria, herbicides or pest resistant crops. So the disadvantage of genetic engineering will be formation of super weeds, existence of new pasture resistance to BT toxin, fear that it may harm human via consumption. Okay, here are some questions to do. Okay, so define the term genetic engineering. So to define it, it's basically to clone some, it's taking in a gene or DNA from one species and change the genetic material of something by removing and inserting gene DNA or alleles. Okay, And B is a flowing diagram. So you can see how it's produced by genetic engineering. So M is chromosomes, N will be gene. And next one is Q, plasmid is Q, okay? And next one is R is a bacterial cell. And O is a insulin. And P is the fermenter. Okay, explain the advantages of asexual reproduction for insulin production by genetic engineering. So it helps to give a genetic identical clone, and it uses lesser energy to reproduce asexually because it only needs one parent. So it goes back to the definition of asexual reproduction again. And it doesn't need gametes, and large quantity of insulin is being produced. So you can also say that have the insulin gene and it produces insulin, and same insulins are being produced, and one cells are engineered, does not have to be repeated again. So okay, that is all for this video. So I hope you understand this biotechnology. If you have anything, please put your answers questions in the comments down below. So see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.